Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfat. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the President of the Supreme Defense Council, the SDC, today chaired the Council's meeting at Sakhir Palace in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty expressed pride in the efforts exerted by His Royal Highness Crown Prince and Prime Minister and his leadership of Team Bahrain to combat the coronavirus. He noted that the team's success has led to a decrease in the number of active cases and an increase in the number of recoveries. His Majesty stated that this also reflects the role of the medical and health caterers, frontliners and volunteers. His Majesty also noted the praise of the WHO Director General Tedros Ghebreyesus of the initiatives and procedures implemented in the kingdom and their success in mitigating the pandemic, as well as his recommendation to document the Bahraini experience to be emulated internationally. The Council reviewed the developments in the Brotherly Republic of Tunisia, expressing wishes of security, stability and prosperity to the Tunisian people under the leadership of President Kais Saied. The Council also reviewed means of developing the Kingdom's technical and technological performance. The SDC then commended the work of Bahrain Defense Force, the Ministry of Interior and the National Guard and their keenness on performing their noble duties to protect the homeland. The National Security Advisor and Secretary General of the SDC, Major General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, briefed the Council on the plans to raise defense, security and health capabilities. The Council concluded by discussing the topics listed on its agenda. The first Deputy President of the Supreme Council of Youth and Sports, President of General Sports Authority and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, held a remote meeting with heads of national clubs to discuss the club's needs and brief them about the policies of the authority. The Deputy President of the authority, Sheikh Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the CEO of the authority, Dr. Abdurrahman Askar, also participated in the meeting. His Highness Sheikh Khalid conveyed the greetings of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to the attendees and praise their efforts in honoring the youth skills through various programs that provides them the opportunity to showcase their skills locally and internationally. He also hailed the efforts of Team Bahrain led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, in curbing the spread of the virus and reaching positive results and ensuring the health and safety of all. His Highness then explained the mechanism of receiving requests from the clubs through direct communication with the authority. He also explained the policy of working at the authority and affirmed that the doors will be open to welcome all sports bodies in order to achieve the strategic desired goals. His Highness affirmed his full support to the clubs and urged all of them to welcome more people and improve their talents in order to discover talented individuals. He urged the authority to protect sportsmen rights, provide a suitable environment for them and encourage them to exert their efforts to make more sports achievements for the kingdom. Under the patronage of the Deputy Prime Minister, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, the graduation ceremony for the Parliamentary Diplomacy Diploma Program was held today in the presence of the Representatives Council Speaker Fawzia Zainal and the Minister of Foreign Affairs Dr. Abdullatif Zayani. The ceremony was organized by Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa Academy for Diplomatic Studies in cooperation with the General Secretariat of the Representatives Council. His Highness the Deputy Premier delivered a speech in which he expressed pleasure to patronize the ceremony, noting that the program is one of the initiatives launched according to the reform project of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and his keenness on cementing the role of diplomacy to promote the kingdom at the international and parliamentary levels. He expressed thanks to His Majesty for his directives to form this academy. His Highness noted that the graduation ceremony reflects the continuous cooperation between the executive and legislative authorities and the complementary relations between official and parliamentary diplomacy and their role in achieving the kingdom's foreign policies and protecting its national interests. He affirmed that the program promoted Bahraini parliamentary action both locally and internationally. His Highness expressed pleasure in the evident cooperation between the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the Representatives' Council, hailing the keenness of Fawzia Zainal on developing the role of the Council by possessing the tools that facilitate positive external interaction. His Highness emphasized that he observes the efforts of the Foreign Affairs Minister with keen interest and appreciation for his role in developing the role of the Ministry and further advancing its employees' performance. He congratulated the graduates and wished them further success and progress.
عن قيمها الأصيلة وطبيعتها المنفتحة على العالم تعزيزاً لمكانتها الإقليمية والدولية. إن إنجاز هذا البرنامج يعكس الجهد المتواصل الذي تقوم به الحكومة ممثلة في وزارة الخارجية لتعزيز العمل البرلماني البحريني على الصعيدين المحلي والخارجي، ويؤكد حرص أصحاب المعالي والسعادة النواب بالمشاركة في أعماله، بأن تكون الدبلوماسية البرلمانية حاضرة ومؤثرة في المشهد السياسي لمملكة البحرين، وإن ما لمسناه وسعدنا به من تعاون بين وزارة الخارجية ومجلس النواب في إنجاز وإنجاح هذا البرنامج لا يبرهن على حرص رئيسة المجلس معالي السيدة فوزية بنت عبد الله زينل على تطوير دور المجلس بامتلاك أدوات التفاعل الإيجابي مع الخارج وإطلاع النواب على أفضل الممارسات الدبلوماسية البرلمانية المعاصرة وتوظيفها في علاقاتهم مع نظرائهم في الدول الشقيقة والصديقة لتحقيق الأهداف الوطنية التي نسعى لها جميعاً. الحضور الكرام، نتابع باهتمام وتقدير ما يقوم به سعادة الدكتور عبد اللطيف الراشد الزياني وزير الخارجية من جهود مشهورة لتطوير دور وزارة الخارجية، والنهوض بأداء منتسبيها بما يواكب المستجدات العالمية. وإن ما تقوم به الأكاديمية للدراسات الدبلوماسية من دور تنويري وتثقيفي وما تنجزه من مبادرات رائدة في تعزيز الدبلوماسية وتطويرها، قد مكنها من أن تكون مركزاً علمياً وعملياً لتأهيل وتخريج جيل دبلوماسي قادر ومتمكن. بهذه المناسبة فإنه يسرني الإعراب عن بالغ الشكر والتقدير للجهاز الإداري للأكاديمية برئاسة المديرة التنفيذية سعادة الدكتورة الشيخة منيرة بنت خليفة بن حمد آل خليفة عن جهودها في الإعداد وتنفيذ هذا البرنامج وغيره. والشكر موصول لأصحاب السعادة السفراء والمحاضرين الذين أسهموا في إثراء أعمال هذا البرنامج بمعارفهم الفكرية وتجاربهم العملية تحقيقاً لأهدافه ومقاصده. كما أنه لا يسعدني إعراب عن تهاني الخالصة لأصحاب المعالي والسعادة خريجي برنامج دبلوم الدبلوماسية البرلمانية النيابية، معرباً عن الثقة بأن ما ناقشوه واطلعوا عليه سيضفي المزيد على تجربتهم البرلمانية ليكون مكملاً ومعززاً لجهود الحكومة وأجهزتها المختلفة في تحقيق مصالح الوطن والمواطن والدفاع عن قضاياه وتوطيد علاقات المملكة مع دول العالم. وختاماً، أسأل المولى العلي القدير أن يوفقنا جميعاً لما فيه الخير والسداد، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The Representatives' Council Speaker also delivered a speech on which she noted that the Parliamentary Diplomacy Diploma Program is considered one of its kind in bolstering parliamentary diplomacy. She noted that the ceremony celebrates a leading national figure, Zaina Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak, noting his role as a Bahraini diplomacy pioneer. She also extended thanks and appreciation to the Foreign Affairs Minister and Ministry for the efforts exerted to launch the program.
سياق التعاون الفعال مع الحكومة الموقرة برئاسة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله. وفي هذا الحفل نحتفي بوجود قامة وطنية شامخة تحضر بيننا اليوم متمثلة في سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة، حيث نرحب بسموه ونستذكر دوره كرائد للدبلوماسية البحرينية والأب المؤسس لها، حيث تولى سموه مهمة السياسة الخارجية للوطن في أواخر ستينيات القرن الماضي ول37 عاماً، وساهم في وضع اللبنات الأولى للدبلوماسية البحرينية وتثبيت أركانها وصياغة معالمها الشامخة، وذلك ترجمة لتوجيهات الأمير الراحل سمو الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة طيب الله ثراه.
For his part, the Minister of Foreign Affairs delivered a speech in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Highness the Deputy Premier on his follow-up and interest in supporting the Ministry's efforts. He also commended the interest of the Representatives Council Speaker in bolstering cooperation between the executive and legislative branches according to the directives of His Majesty the King and the decisions of the government under the leadership of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister.
كما لا يفوتني أن أشكر الإدارة التنفيذية لأكاديمية محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة للدراسات الدبلوماسية برئاسة سعادة الدكتورة نيرة بنت خليفة آل خليفة على الجهود المخلصة التي بذلت للانتقال بالدبلوماسي البحريني من ممارسة الدبلوماسية التقليدية المحدودة إلى الدبلوماسية الشاملة لمواكبة متطلبات العصر، الأمر الذي يضع الأكاديمية على عتبة تطور نوعي في الفكر والأداء يدشن مرحلة جديدة من العمل الدبلوماسي نفخر بها ونعتز. والشكر موصول لأصحاب المعالي والسعادة السفراء الذين أسهموا بمعارفهم وخبرتهم في إثراء هذا البرنامج المهم.
At the end of the ceremony, the Speaker of the Representatives Council and the Minister of Foreign Affairs presented the participants with their certificates. Deputy Prime Minister His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa received today at his office in Qutaybiyah Palace the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Pakistan Makhdoom Shah Mahmood Qureshi upon his visit to the kingdom in the presence of the Minister of Foreign Affairs Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Zayani. His Highness welcomed Minister Qureshi, affirming that this visit is in line with the deep-rooted historic bilateral relations and cooperation and the mutual keenness on further developing in various fields. During the meeting, a number of regional and international topics of mutual interest where both sides affirmed the importance of joint action to maintain regional and international security and stability. For his part, Minister Qureshi expressed pleasure in visiting the kingdom, affirming that the meeting of the Bahrain-Pakistan Joint Ministerial Committee reflects the two countries' keenness on strengthening relations. The meeting was attended by the Foreign Ministry Undersecretary for Political Affairs, Dr. Sheikh Abdullah bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, the Ambassador of Bahrain to Pakistan, Muhammad Ibrahim Muhammad, and the Ambassador of Pakistan to Bahrain, Muhammad Ayub. Under the patronage of the Chief of Public Security, Lieutenant General Tariq Al-Hassan, the Criminal Investigation Directorate organized a virtual meeting entitled Presenting the Reality of Anti-Human Trafficking in the Arab World, Bahrain's Case. The Lieutenant General conveyed the greetings of the Minister of Interior to the participants and congratulated His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, and the Minister over the Kingdom being ranked in the first category in anti-human trafficking for the fourth year in a row, as per the U.S. State Department's annual report. He praised Bahrain's achievements in this regard, thanks to the directives of His Majesty the King to enforce equality and human rights. Then Brigadier Mohammed bin Dana expressed pride in the achievements on an international level and that the ministry is proceeding in safeguarding the principles of human rights, security and stability. And now we are joined by the GCC regional representative of the UN Office on Drugs and Crime, Judge Hatem Ali. Hello, Judge Hatem. It's good to have you here with us tonight. Can you tell us about your participation and how you value Bahrain's efforts in combating human trafficking?
Thank you very much for receiving us and for helping shading the light on this very decent opportunity provided by the Ministry of Interior and the National Committee on Combating Human Trafficking in the celebration of the International Day Against Trafficking in Person that our organization launches on a yearly basis exactly for the same reason, to help the countries and to help the communities learn more about this phenomena of trafficking in human beings that is increasing on a yearly basis and leaving victims that have crossed the lines of 30 million around the world last year alone. Actually, our participation in today's event and all the interventions from the various national and international community in the Kingdom of Bahrain have actually reflected the commitment of the Kingdom in fighting human trafficking and in providing all the care and support for its victims in the Kingdom through the efforts of the member agencies of the National Committee on Combating Human Trafficking. Actually, we are honored as the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime to be the partners of the Kingdom of Bahrain and the National Committee. We have actually done a lot together through the past 5 years alone. Bahrain have actually presented a national domestic law against human trafficking, have established a shelter for the victims of human trafficking, provided all the guarantees that actually addresses the areas of vulnerability in the community of labor in the Kingdom that reduce the chances for human trafficking, and have provided a lot of help and support. So we are actually glad to have participated in this decent event organized by the National Committee at the hospitals of His Excellency Sheikh Rashid Al Khalifa, the Minister of Interior, with the participation of all the member agencies and our colleagues from the United Nations and from IOM. It was a very decent opportunity and reflects the political commitment that the Kingdom of Bahrain has to the portfolio of combating human trafficking and providing the care and support to its victims.
Mm-hmm. That is truly remarkable. GCC Regional Representative of the UN Office on Drugs and Crime, Judge Hatem Ali, thank you very much for joining us. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of Pakistan, Makhdoom Shah Mahmood Qureshi, arrived today in Bahrain on an official visit to participate in the second meeting of the Bahrain-Pakistan Joint Ministerial Committee. He was received by the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdullatif bin Rashid Zayani, the Ministry's Undersecretary for Consular and Administrative Affairs, Ambassador Tawfiq Ahmed Al-Mansour, the Ambassador of Bahrain to Pakistan, Muhammad Ibrahim Muhammad, and the Ambassador of Pakistan to Bahrain, Muhammad Ayoub. The Minister of Health, Faiqa Saleh, made a statement in a joint briefing with the National Communication Center in which he discussed the role of the ministry in the Supreme Council for Health. The ministry affirmed that the Kingdom has designated the Supreme Council for Health to be in charge of drawing the National Health Strategy and following up on it, as well as policies of caterers training. health insurance, scientific research, management of health institutions, and governance of the health sector. She added that health insurance policies will cover first aid, government and military hospitals. As for the private sector, it includes various private hospitals, whereas the health services project will be based on the Shifa Fund. The minister said that the ministry's role will be to offer and regulate health services and that it remains committed to increase the quality of such services. She said that the ministry will establish a central unit for diagnosing diseases and that the National Genome Center will establish a national database. She added that the Finnair Research Center for Contagious Diseases will carry out a comprehensive study via labs and centers for research and training. The National Medical Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus COVID-19 noted that booster shots help individuals maximize immunity against COVID-19, which in turn lowers the risk of complications from severe illness and death. Booster shots have been attributed to significantly reduced deaths, as zero deaths and hospitalizations were recorded in Bahrain for individuals after 2 weeks of receiving a booster shot. Vaccines protect the community, and it is crucial to get vaccinated as scheduled, particularly for individuals at risk of developing complications. The national vaccination campaign continues to witness a wide turnout of citizens and residents. The Ministry of Health announced that 1,104,678 had taken the first dose of the vaccine, while 1,047,845 had taken the second, and 131,192 had taken the booster dose. The ministry renewed its call for the community to commit to all precautionary measures and take the initiative to register for the coronavirus vaccination. And the Ministry of Health said today that the number of active coronavirus cases reached 851, with 80 recoveries and 108 registered new cases. 57 of the new registered cases are expatriates, 32 are contact of active cases, and 16 are travel-related. The ministry urges everyone to comply with the guidelines issued by the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus.